In this video, I will show how you can make your bike look from this to this. So let's get started. For this DIY, you need a spray paint. This is quick drying acrylic spray paint. This is gloss black. You will need some masking tape to cover those areas that does not have to be painted. You will need a chart paper or newspaper or something so that you can keep it at the base of the part to be painted, so that when you're spraying the paint, the residue will go onto the chart paper. You will need sandpapers or emery papers. You can start with 60 grit and then go to 320 grit and can go to 180 grit and higher. The higher the number here, the more finer the paper is. So higher number is used for finishing stages and a smaller number is coarse paper and is used for the initial phases. So start with coarse paper, that is a smaller numbers, and finish it with higher number.
The first thing that you can do is to spray the paint directly over the area where you want to paint it after sanding it. But in that case, you will need to cover the entire surrounding so that you do not spray paint elsewhere. Moreover, if you do this DIY without removing the part, you may miss out to paint a few parts. Moreover, it needs time to dry, and in the meantime, it will be prone to dust and debris. So, to remove this part, you can watch my video on how to replace the bike lock set by clicking the I button above or by clicking the link in the description. So now when we have removed the mounting plate, we can either cover the lock with a masking tape or simply remove the lock for our ease. Now we need to remove these two 10mm bolts to disconnect the lock. Now the finish of the paint depends on how well you sand the component to be painted. Ideally, we should sandblast the component to remove all the old paint, but as this is a DIY, you can use an emery paper of 60 grit or so, which will be enough to remove all the residual paint. And finish it with a finer paper like a 320 or so. Here in this case, I did not sand the part properly and I did use a very fine grit, due to which all the residual paint was not removed, and I had to spray many coats of paint for proper finish. So my advice to you is to use a coarse grit paper and finish it with a finer grit, which will make your life a lot easier. So simply take a small piece of emery paper and sand it in one direction until you smooth out the entire surface. So this is how it looks after sanding. So as I have told earlier, for better finish you need to sand it totally and you may have to repeat this process. Now we have to wash it to remove the sanding dust or paint dust. After washing, dry it with a cloth before painting. Now we will spray several layers of thin coat and maintain a gap of at least 15 minutes before any two successive layers. As you can see the spot, this is due to the uneven sanding. Though we can cover it with several layers of spray, but you can avoid this mistake by sanding it properly. Now wait for 15 minutes and apply the second coat. Now what I'm actually doing is that I'm spraying thick layer of spray on this part and thin layer on this part. As I've already told, if you sand it properly, you need not do in this way. Moreover, if you do it properly, 3 coats of spray will be more than enough. So as you can see, after several layers of spray, this is how it looks. Now spray on opposite side as well.
Now after the final spray, leave the part for at least 6 hours to cure. Now if you want to check whether the paint has cured or not, take a sharp object and penetrate it gently into the component. If the paint is still soft, then it needs more time to cure. As you can see, this is not yet cured. Now after an hour, it looks like this and has come out awesome. Now if you have removed the lock in the beginning, then put it back and tighten the bolt. If you don't know how to install this back into your bike, watch my video on how to replace your bike lock set, the link to which is available in the description. So this is how it looks now. Thank you for watching.